Hello friends, welcome to my GCC class. And in this class we will learn virtualization of CPU, memory and IO devices, and that will come under third unit, virtualization. The virtualization of CPU, memory and IO devices, that is we are going to virtualize the hardware devices. And how we are going to virtualize these hardware devices? To support such virtualization, that is hardware virtualization, a processor should have a special running mode and a special set of instructions, and that those are known as hardware assisted virtualization. By using this special running mode and instructions, that is instruction set architecture ISA, a processor should have these things to do the hardware assisted virtualization. And nowadays the x86 processors are having such special running modes and a such set of instructions to do the hardware virtualizations. And here the virtual machine monitor and guest OS, those will run on different modes. Those two will execute on different modes, and all sensitive instructions of guest OS and its applications are trapped by this virtual machine monitor. So in the last video itself we have seen VMM is here. On the top of VMM we are having guest OS. And if there is any special instructions are executed by this application, and those special instructions will be trapped by this virtual machine monitor. And all the applications are, that is non-sensitive instructions, can be directly executed on the hardware itself. This is hardware itself. And to save the processor state, we should have mode switching that will be implemented in the hardware itself. Hardware support for virtualization. In modern operating systems and processors, and they permit the multiple processors to run simultaneously, which is otherwise called as multiprocessing system. Multiprocessing systems. That means multiple process can execute simultaneously, and if all the instructions from different process tries to access the physical hardware directly, means the system will be crashed. Hence, all the processor has two modes. The first one is user mode and second one is supervisor mode. The instructions running in supervised mode are called as privileged instructions or the sensitive instructions. Sensitive instructions, and all the other instructions are unprivileged instructions that will run on the user mode. User mode of processor. User mode of processor. The CPU virtualization. Here VM is a duplicate of an existing computer system, that we know very well. So this is the physical hardware and this is the physical machine. So on the top of this we are having virtual machine. So virtual machine is here. It will act as a duplicate of existing hardware machine, that we know very well. And if there is any unprivileged instructions from virtual machine, unprivileged instruction, if it is comes from virtual machine, means that can directly execute on the hardware machine. What about the privileged instruction? So that will cause the architecture of CPU virtualizable. And if you want to virtualize the CPU, if virtual machine's unprivileged instructions run on CPU's user mode, so the instructions will execute on CPU's user mode, and the virtual machine monitor runs in the supervisor mode of this physical CPU. VMM will be exist here, and this is the place of virtual machine. Then the privileged instructions means maybe control and behavior sensitive instructions of this virtual machine. If such virtual machine instructions comes here, means immediately the virtual machine monitor will trap those instructions and that will execute under the supervisor mode. Here the VMM will act as a unified mediator. It will act as a unified mediator between the hardware and this virtual machine. So to access from different virtual machines, to guarantee, for what purpose? To guarantee the correctness and stability of the whole system. So this is called as CPU virtualization. And this is memory virtualization. In traditional execution environment, the operating system maintains mapping of virtual memory to machine memory by using a page table. So the page table is a one stage mapping from virtual memory to machine memory. But nowadays in modern x86 CPUs, which includes two things. First one is memory management unit, that is MMU, and the translation look aside buffer, that is TLB, to optimize the virtual memory performance. And the virtualization involves sharing the physical system memory, that is RAM, and this RAM will be dynamically allocated to physical memory of these virtual machines. That is, here we are having hardware, that is the physical machine. Physical machine should have the memory. Every physical machine is having some memory, that is RAM, and this RAM portion will be allocated to this virtual machine. All the virtual machine are having all those things, CPU, memory and IO devices. So the portion of this physical RAM will be allocated to this virtual machine. This is called as memory virtualization. In the memory virtualization, we are having two stage mapping process, and that should maintain by the guest OS and the virtual machine monitor. That is, we need to map virtual memory to physical memory. Virtual memory is available in virtual machine and physical memory is available in virtual machine monitor. And second stage mapping is physical memory to machine memory. Physical memory is VMM memory and machine memory is physical C, that is OS memory, physical memory, that is RAM, sorry, physical RAM memory. Hence, the guest OS continues to control mapping of virtual address to physical memory address of this particular virtual machine. But the guest OS cannot directly access the virtual memory, that is actual machine memory. How it is possible? By using this virtual machine monitor. So the VMM is responsible for mapping the guest to physical memory to actual machine memory. Here, and this is the machine, physical machine, and this is the virtual machine monitor, and this is virtual machine. The virtual machine is having virtual memory. Virtual machine is having virtual memory, and the virtual machine monitor is having physical memory. And this RAM is having machine address, machine memory. First we need to map this virtual memory to physical memory, and then the physical memory will be mapped into actual machine memory. So this is called as memory virtualization. The two level memory mapping procedure is explained by this diagram. Here we are having one virtual machine and the another virtual machine here. And virtual machine one, we are having process one and process two. In process 1, we are executing so many jobs. This is job 1 and etc. up to job n will be executed here. And this is the, this portion is the virtual machine monitor. VMM. That address will be mapped with the physical memory address. So this is virtual memory and this is physical memory. And again, those physical memory will be mapped into machine memory. So this is the machine memory. This is actual hardware RAM or a RAM address. And this is VMM address and this is the virtual machine address. So this is called as two level memory mapping. That means in any instruction which is actually executed in the VM, that is not actually executed in the VM's RAM, actually that will be executed in the hardware machine. The page table in memory virtualization and maintaining a separate page table by guest OS and virtual machine monitor. So this will maintain a separate page table and VMM will maintain a separate page table. So VMM page table is called as shadow page table. The page table maintained by virtual machine monitor is called as shadow page table. Translate virtual memory to machine memory and physical memory address are translated to machine address by using another set of page table which is defined by the hypervisor. I/O virtualization. In I/O virtualization involves managing the routing of I/O requests between virtual devices and a shared physical hardware. So in the physical hardware we are having I/O devices. In virtual machine, we should allocate these I/O devices to virtual machine in the form of software. So there are three ways to implement this I/O virtualization. First one is full device emulation, para virtualization and direct I/O. And all these functions, that is device emulation, identification, interrupts and DMA, direct memory access, are replicated in software itself. And this software is located in virtual machine monitor and act as a virtual device. And I/O access request of the guest OS are trapped to the virtual machine monitor which interact with the I/O devices. The device emulation for I/O virtualization, that is the device emulation for I/O virtualization, will be implemented inside the middle layer. Middle layer is actually the virtualization layer and that will map the real I/O devices into virtual device for the guest device driver. And in this diagram, and this is the guest OS which is implemented in the virtual machine and we are having physical machines. And in between we are having virtualization layer. And this is the real device. And this is the real hardware device. And here also we are having one device. This is called as guest device driver. And in the virtualization layer, we are having the actual virtual device that will be allocated to this virtual machine. And what are the purpose of virtualization here? That will emulate the virtual devices and remap the guest and real I/O addresses. Multiplex and device the physical device. Multiplex and drives the physical drive I/O features. So these are the functionalities of virtualization layer. And this virtualization layer will actually gives the route between the guest OS and the physical machine. The direct I/O virtualization. Here current I/O virtualization implementation focus on networking for mainframes. And the virtualization faces a lot of challenges and sometimes they may crash the entire system. Here, the software based I/O virtualization requires very high overhead of device emulation and the hardware assisted virtualization also very much critical. Virtualizing in multi-core processors. Here, integrating multiple processor cores in a single chip. We are having more number of cores in a single processor and this is processor. In a processor we are having more number of cores. So this is core 1, core 2, etc. up to core n. So many cores will be integrated into single processor. So virtualizing multiple processor, that is multi-core processor, is more complicated when compared to Unicore processor virtualization. Here we will face two difficulties. First one is application program must be parallelized to use all cores fully. That is, all the cores should be fully utilized by the applications. For that, we need a new programming model and new languages and libraries are needed to make parallel programming easier. Hence, all the cores should be utilized fully, then only this virtualization should be successful, otherwise it will be failed. And the second one is, software must explicitly assign tasks to the cores, and which is very complex problem. So to overcome this, we required better scheduling algorithms and resource management policies also. The physical versus virtual processor cores. In multi-core virtualization method, the abstraction of low details of the processor cores. That means, in this diagram, we are having four virtual CPUs. This is the virtual CPU 1, CPU 2, CPU 3 and CPU 4. So we are having four virtual CPUs to the software, and the software will be executed here in this guest virtual machine. But only three cores are actually present. Three cores means the physical cores. These are the physical cores. Here we are having only three physical cores. The virtual CPU moving from one core to another and temporarily suspending the execution of virtual CPU when there are no appropriate cores on which it can run. That is, the threads will be utilized to those virtual cores. Threads will be come to the virtual core and that will be executed actually on the physical core. And if your particular virtual machine does not have any physical core, and immediately that will suspending the execution of that particular thread or process. Okay. Virtual hierarchy that shows how the workspace is shared for improved performance and performance isolation. So in this diagram, we are having three levels of cache. The cache 1 is close to cores of the multiprocessor, that is multi-core processor, and second one is L2 cache, which is common for entire multi-core processor, and external cache, which is otherwise called as DRAM. In these hierarchies, first level locates data blocks close to the cores and that is used for faster access, which establishes a shared cache domain and which is used for faster communication. In the first level, it also provides isolation between independent workloads. If there is a miss in cache 1, then it invokes the cache 2. And that's all about the virtualization of CPU, memory and I/O devices. And for more information, please go through the textbook. Thank you.